As Pastor Terry Jones' plans for the 9/11 anniversary became public, Muslims around the world gathered in protest. In Pakistan, they burned the U.S. flag. In Afghanistan, they burned the flag and chanted death to America. In Indonesia, the president warned of an interfaith backlash.
What is being planned by Reverend Terry Jones and his followers in Florida, the United States of America, to openly and before the public burn the Holy Al-Quran, not only wound the feelings of the Islamic Ummah, but I am also certain the feelings of the followers of other faith, and indeed can threaten international peace and security.
In the Gaza Strip, the Hamas prime minister vowed allegiance to the Quran and called Pastor Jones a criminal liar. In the U.S., clergy leaders were quick to condemn the plans as well.
I say, shame on you.
Bearing false witness against your neighbor is against the Quran, is against the Bible, is against the Gospels, and this is why we are here, so we have to be here.
Even President Obama weighed in, concerned about the safety of U.S. citizens and troops abroad.
This stunt that he is talking about pulling could greatly endanger our young men and women in uniform who are in Iraq, who are in Afghanistan.
Missions experts say these kinds of events can be catastrophic for Christians in Muslim lands. Carl Moeller heads Open Doors USA, a ministry to persecuted Christians.
Christians around the world will suffer. There's almost no doubt about that. We will most likely see Christians killed because of these Quran burnings. Now that's a huge weight of responsibility for this church to bear.
Many American Christians expressed astonishment that such a tiny church could cause such a controversy and wondered how much damage the incident would cause to already fractured Christian-Muslim relations. Dale Hurd, CBN News.